Welcome to the next video in our guide on learning how to start selling online with WooCommerce. My name is Cal Evans, and I'm a WordPress and PHP expert. And in this video, we'll learn about the different kind of payment methods in WooCommerce and how orders will be processed in your system. Now, before we start, just a quick reminder that you can download our PDF guide at the URL given in the description of this video. In it, you'll find a more detailed explanation on this topic, as well as all the rest of the steps to start selling online. So, let's begin. These days, if you have a phone, or a computer, or a tablet, you can build a website and create an endless list of products and take your customers' money easily and safely. Let's look at exactly how you do that. From your site's admin dashboard, navigate to WooCommerce Settings and find the Payments tab. You will see that WooCommerce offers the following payment methods out of the box to process your orders: WooCommerce Payments, Direct Bank Transfer, Check Payments, and Cash on Delivery, or COD. In order to allow direct bank transfers, check payments, or COD, the process is as easy as to click on the Setup button, add the details requested, and click on the Enable button and then save the changes. Nevertheless, there is a high chance that you won't need these payment methods. The most accepted payment method in online business nowadays is the credit card. In order for you to accept most common credit cards, you can use the WooCommerce Payments or install a plugin for PayPal, Stripe, or Square. There are two newer payment processors that you can choose from: Amazon Pay, and as we mentioned, WooCommerce Payments. Let's do a quick comparison of them based on three crucial metrics for most online store operators: percentage of transaction fees, and do they offer reoccurring payments, which are commonly used for subscriptions. All three process reoccurring payments, but as you can see, there are differences between them in the fees they charge you and in the per transaction fee percentage that they take. To help you decide which one to use, check our video on how to choose the best payment processor for your e-commerce site. A link to that video is in the description below. Now, once you've decided which payment processor you're going to use, being able to accept payments is as simple as setting up an account with the payment processor, installing the WooCommerce plugin, and then configuring the plugin with your credentials that the payment processor will give you. Most payment processors will give you an API key or a set of keys for you to put into the plugin. The plugin will tell you precisely what is needed and in most cases includes a link for you to follow to get your authorization credentials. Once you've selected a payment processor, be prepared to spend some time setting up the account, proving who you are, and providing a lot of personal information. Now that you can accept payments, it's time to learn how your checkout process works. We call this your checkout workflow, and there are many different options. For the sake of simplicity, let's focus on two different workflows and we'll discuss a couple of options. The most straightforward workflow is the single page checkout. The name describes it pretty accurately. When the customer clicks checkout, you present them with a single page that collects all of their information. Now, the upside is you don't force your users to fill out several pages of information. They do it all at once and they're finished. And this is the old school way of doing things. Newer systems allow you to break the collection of information across several different pages. This means users are not hit with 10 or 20 fields to fill out all at once, but that the data is logically grouped, and most site owners are now using this new wizard workflow. The problem with both workflows is cart abandonment. On the single page workflow, the user might feel that it's too much information to fill out right now. They'll intend to come back later and finish, but they rarely do. With the wizard workflow, users may begin to feel like they're in a never-ending quest to purchase your product, and they'll abandon the cart after the third screen just out of frustration. Which is the best way for you largely depends on your customers. Generally speaking, if you're selling a low-cost product, then collecting the minimal amount of information on a single-page checkout offers less friction for your users. Higher-priced or complex offerings can benefit from the multi-page cart wizard because the user is much more committed to the purchasing of the product and thus will accept the higher level of friction. Out of the box, WooCommerce comes with a single-page checkout workflow. Like everything else in WooCommerce, there are both free and paid plugins that will allow you to customize your checkout workflow without resorting to writing a single line of code. The place to start exploring these is the WooCommerce Extension Marketplace. Because they're included in the WooCommerce Extension Marketplace, these vendors tend to be a little more reputable. Setting up your payment processor is going to take you some time. Depending on your local regulations and the payment processor you choose, you may not be able to complete it in a single day. Don't worry about this. You'll get through it and move on to much more exciting things. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click on the subscribe button on your screen to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the bell icon also, so that YouTube will notify you every time we release a new video. Finally, follow us on social media to stay up to date about all the news, trending content, and resources for successful website management that we share. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.